in what has already been a historic season for Auburn softball. The Tigers' first super regional appearance was indeed one for the record books.
This is a team of firsts. You know, this is uncharted water for them, and that's one of the things we keep trying to stress to them, that it's nothing more than just a softball game. It's just like, you know, back in August when we started and back in February when we started playing. It's a softball game.
Auburn University entered the bottom of the seventh inning trailing by 5 against Louisiana Lafayette. They plated 5 runs with the benefit of only one hit.
Had a lot of mentally sound at-bats during that seventh inning because it could have been easily a swing and miss at one of those balls that she was throwing, but I think every batter that went up that inning was focused on their pitch.
And when Louisiana Lafayette scored in the top of the eighth inning, it took little-used Whitney Jordan to deliver the game-winning hit in the bottom of the eighth.
She has really been hitting the ball good all week long. I mean, if you saw, all 4 coaches were, you know, sitting there, and her response was, "Can you give us a ground ball?" Yes. There was a few other little colorful words in there, but yes, she can get it. You know, I'll get you the ground ball. And by golly, she went up there and she did it. We got our work cut out for us tomorrow because they're a good ball club. But I tell you, it's the things that we've been saying about this team. Figuring out ways to win and going out there and a different hero, that little freshman, he went up there and got the big ground ball for us, and that was huge. So it is a team, and all 20 of them are ready for their number to be called.
I think it shows our character and how we're never defeated. We're not done until, like, we scored most of those runs with 2 outs in the seventh inning to tie it back up, and I think that just shows what kind of team Auburn is. Like, we don't give up, and you're going to have to play a full 7 innings with 3 outs to finish the game with us.
Even though they left 20 runners on base in this game, Auburn escapes with a 12-11 extra inning win. Now they need to win just 1 of 2 games Saturday morning to advance to the College World Series for the first time in school history.
This was an exciting game, and I have to thank the fans because, I mean, it was kind of a warm day, and they didn't leave. They did not leave. I mean, it was a great game to watch. The girls really, you know, left it on the field, and the team, myself, the players, the staff, want to thank them because you saw the support, and it means so much to us to see those people in the stands cheering like they are, because it's, you know, it's a great feeling.
We started with, a couple fans trickling in here and there, and now we're packed out and sold out within 30 minutes of every game. And, I mean, it means a lot to us when we can just interact with the fans ourselves and we're more on the field, and it gets us fired up. As long as they stay fired up, we're going to stay fired up.
Another sellout crowd is expected bright and early on Saturday morning. If necessary, game 2 would follow shortly thereafter with a trip to Oklahoma City hanging in the balance. At Auburn, Alabama, I'm Brent Weber with your scorecard scribblings.